Radio.
Prepare yourself.
Ang silid aralan sa radyo, hating namin ay makabagong paraan ng pagtuturo at kaalaman. Mapaumaga, tanghali o hapon man yan, ang istasyong magbibigay impormasyon kahit saan man.
Be ready for something big.
Alright, here we go.
106.3 Dance Radio. Doña Aurora National High School, Santa Rita, Aurora, Isabela.
This
106.3 DWBR-FM. Pre-calculus, Advanced Algebra, Intermediate Algebra, Trigonometry, Elementary Algebra, Geometry. Mga aralin dapat tuklasin. Mathematics Learning Area. Mathematics, kahit saan, kahit kailan. Mathematics, maaasahan inyong tututukan dito sa 106.3 DWDR-FM. Basta Dance Radio, learning is amazing!
Hello! Okay, medyo bawas nga ako. Nagigiba ko yata yung microphone nila. Good day, everyone! It's Monday! Kamusta po kayong lahat? Bawasan pa natin. Sana po ay nasa mabuti kayong kalagayan ngayon. Hindi ko sanay. Okay, so sana po ay lahat kayo ay maayos ang kalagayan sa panahong ito. It's 19 days before Christmas. Okay, magandang araw po sa ating lahat, sa ating mga mag-aaral at lahat ng naaabot ng ating station. Ang lamig ng simoy ng hangin, masarap matulog at kumigop ng mainit na sabaw na nakahain. Lahat tayo'y parang nagiging antukin. Pero sa ating live streaming, kami, kayo'y gigisingin, o diba? Kaya naman, welcome to Math Alarm sa Facebook Live, o diba? Ay, sorry, bawal akong tumawa. Okay, December 6, 2021, ito po ang week 3 na live streaming po ng ating Mathematics 7 for Shift 1, Quarter 2. Patuloy na inaanyayahan po natin lahat ng grade levels, ano, grade 8, grade 9, and grade 10. Kung kayo'y nandyan, pwede kayong sumalit, manalo ng load. Malay nyo, sa inyo lahat mapunta ang mga pa-load natin ngayon, di ba? Swerte. Kaya naman, dahil week 3 na tayo, pa-comment naman dyan ang hashtag Math7Week3 para naman may pang-send kayo na screenshot sa ating mga teachers na iba-iba ang content. Di ba? Okay. So, para ma-check, ano? Para nakikita din namin, ano, kung hindi nyo lang alam, minomonitor namin lahat ng nagko-comment. Sana kayo ay nandyan na, pasok na. At kung medyo mawala ang internet connection, antabay lang tayo at kami talagang magbabalik. Binabati po natin lahat ng nanonood at nakikinig sa ating station. Shoutout po sa aking Mudra Bells na nanonood ngayon. Hello Mudra! Hello Nanay Lena! And of course, sa aking mga anak, Elijah and Trevor. At hindi pwedeng kalimutan to my bebe. May ganun talaga. Sa ating mga kasamahan sa math learning area na nandito sa school na ngayon, na busy. And of course, meron din tayong kasama na nandyan sa bahay. Hello, Sir Sunny. Magpalakas ka. And hello, Ma'am Naida, na nandyan din sa kanyang bahay. Hello po, dyan, ano, na busy sila, Ma'am Cora, Ma'am Delma, Ma'am Marife, Ma'am Marilyn, Ma'am Marley Jane. Hello sa mga estudyante dyan, mga 7 sinning, 7 kultura, comment at diretsyohin at tapusin ang ating programa. Hello din sa mga grade 8 na nanonood, 8SPJ at 8SPA. Hello mga anak kung kayo'y nandyan. Good morning! Yours truly is Ma'am Rowella S. Santos and my partner. Nanibago kayo, no? Lakas na energy nito. Abangan nyo. Okay. Kailangan taasan mo. Okay. Sorry. My partner is Ma'am Janice. Go, go, go!
Magandang hapon po sa ating lahat. Ayan, Ma'am Ella, Diyos ko po. Ano ba yan?
Naninibago ako na iba ang aking katabi. Mahirap pa lang. Oo, mahirap pa lang ano, nagiging iba ang katabi. By the way, katabi sa pag-host, diba?
Pag-host pa rin ng usapan dito.
Ayan.
Oo naman. Oo naman.
Permanent ang ating katabi.
Yeah.
Ayan.
Okay.
So, bago tayo ano mapalayo sa ating topic, gusto kong batiin ang 7 Bonifacio at ang 7 Aguinaldo. Hello mga anak! And also, sana may maligaw na nanonood ang 8 Burgundy, Beige, and Crimson. At syempre, hindi ko makakalimutang batiin ang aking dalawang anak. Hello Janelle and hello si John. At ganoon na din ang aking hubby na nandyan lang po sa tabi-tabi. Magandang hapon po sa ating lahat! So ngayong hapon na ito, we will have another live streaming from the math department. So Ma'am Ella, I think pwede mo nang ipakilala ang ating dalawang host.
Yes, in fairness.
Pati I should say, learning
faculty. Talagang tinaasan niya naman, di ba? Natuwa naman ako doon. Okay. So makakasama po natin ang ating mga learning facility. Naninibago ako sa tindi ng pick-up ng mic niya. Ang lakas. Okay. So ang ating facilitators po ngayon, Teacher Jenny D. Carino, Teacher Marvy C. De La Cruz, our electronic raffle organizers, of course, dahil dito may nananalo, kaya sila ang nandyan. Teacher Judith S. Gamilo and Teacher Mylin J. Ralutin. And of course, our PowerPoint presenter, Ma'am, or Teacher Lori Lee Vinitura. Shout out po sa ating head teacher, Pansit, sorry. Hello, Mami, nandito na kami ngayon. Ma'am Merlinda Di Dante, sabi niya, ngiti daw tayo. Subukan niyo yung ngiti na hindi nakikita yung bibig. Mata daw ngingiti pa. Ano kaya yun? Hello din po sa ating Assistant Principal Ma'am Ruby R. Guillermo and to our Chief Education Supervisor Officer in Charge Sir Rodrigo V. Pascua. Magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. Okay, ayan. So ang ating RBI ngayon is all about the laws of exponents. So bago yan, gusto nating pasalamatan ng ating sponsor dahil sa kanya, kaya maraming nananalong mga bata. Maraming salamat po, Ma'am Larna Tan Nevado. At more blessings po ang babalik sa inyo sa pagbabahagi nyo ng inyong blessings sa ating paaralan at mga estudyante. Maraming salamat po, Ma'am. And of course, sabi ko nga, ang ating lesson is all about the laws of exponents. Ayan, makikita nyo sa ating screen ang ating title, kaya naman paki-comment name, section, and title of the lesson. Ayan, para naman i-screenshot nyo na, kailangan mga anak ang screenshot, hindi yung pagtugtog pa lang, pasimula pa lang, at tatlong segundo pa lang, mag-screenshot na kayo, hindi namin alam kung matala ba yun, kung EP o ESP ba. Kailangan, nakikita yung nakalagay na yan, Math Alive sa Facebook Live, yan yan nasa baba, para may clue kami na pang math talaga ang pinapanood ninyo. Okay. Name, section, and title of the lesson. Mars, ano nga ba ang ating objectives ngayon?
Okay, so for the objectives today, number one, may dalawa tayo. We have illustrates the laws of exponents. Then number two, multiplies and divides polynomials.
Yan, ang saya ng lesson. Kaya abangan nyo mga anak, ano, malaking bagay po ito para matulungan namin kayo sa inyong aralin, manood kayo sa ating live discussion kasi kino-cover namin yung buong week na lesson na kailangan nyong matutunan. Kaya sana makinig kayo, abangan at makijoin kayo sa ating mga palaro. At bago yan, bago tayo mag-RBI, ibibigay ko ng hudya para sa ating hula mo, load mo. Kaya naman, hula-hula na, hindi mo na magbibigay ng clue kasi ang gagaling yung mag- comment, di ba? So lahat po ng mga nakikinig dyan, pwedeng-pwede kayong humula at manalo ng tumataging ting na 30 pesos worth of load. Ang isa-send nyo lang na template ay name, section, hula. Yung word na hula, kailangang makita ng ating tagapili dito, no? Kaya kailangang include din nyo. And of course, your cellphone number. Ano ang laman ng kahon na ito? O, diba? Kaya mamaya, biglang sisingit ko lang kung meron nang nakakuha. Kaya comment lang ng comment, tuloy-tuloy lang para malay nyo, kayo na ang mananalo. So wag na wag kayong aalis, magbabalik kami agad. Pakinggan po natin ang ating RBI lessons. Stay tuned!
Mag-aalis!
Yes!
Learning is amazing!
A wonderful day to our grade 7 learners! I am Teacher Rowella S. Santos, and I will be with you until we finish our lesson about laws of exponents. Are you ready?
Yes, ma'am!
Very good! Let us have a review of what we have discussed during the last week's lesson. What did we discuss last week?
Ma'am, we discussed how to evaluate algebraic expressions into variables.
Yes, that's right. What else?
We also discussed the addition and subtraction of polynomials.
Very good. How do we evaluate algebraic expressions in two variables, dear learners?
Ma'am, to evaluate algebraic expressions, we substitute the given value of the variables to the given expression and then simplify the expression using the order of operations.
Amazing! It seems that you really understood our past lesson. For today's lesson, we shall illustrate the different laws of exponents. My dear learners, let us have a simple exercise in addition of numbers and you can answer them at the same time. Okay, let's start. 1 plus 1.
2, ma'am.
2 plus 1.
3, ma'am.
3 plus 1.
4, ma'am.
Very good. How about this one? 4 plus 4.
8, ma'am.
8 plus 4.
12, ma'am.
Perfect! Easy, right, dear learners?
Yes, ma'am!
This process is what you call repeated addition. How about this one? 2 times 2.
4, ma'am.
4 times 2.
8, ma'am.
8 times 2.
16, ma'am.
Very good, dear learners! This process is what you call repeated multiplication. This process of repeated multiplication is applied in our lesson today about exponents. What is an exponent?
Exponent is the small letter or number or any symbol written at the upper right corner of an expression, ma'am.
Very good! What else?
Exponent refers to the number of times a number or variable is multiplied by itself, ma'am.
Awesome! Exponent is the small letter or any symbol written at the upper right corner of an expression and tells how many times a number or variable is multiplied by itself. In our exercise of repeated multiplication, that is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 equals 16. How many times did we multiply 2 by itself?
4 times, ma'am.
You are correct. And what do you call 4?
4 is the exponent, ma'am.
Yes, it's the exponent. And what do you call the number we multiplied several times?
The number we multiplied several times is the base, ma'am.
You got it right. It's the base. Can you give another example and identify the base and the exponent?
Yes, ma'am. 5 raised to 7 power, ma'am. 5 is the base and 7 is the exponent, ma'am.
Very good. Give another example.
M raised to 9 power, ma'am. The base is M and the exponent is 9, ma'am.
Perfect. How about this example? 6x cubed. What is the base and exponent of 6x cubed?
Ma'am, in 6x cubed, the base of the exponent 3 is x.
Nice! How about 6? Can we not consider it as the base of the exponent 3, and why?
No, ma'am. 6 is not considered as part of the base of the exponent 3 because 6 has an exponent of 1 and it is only x that has the exponent 3.
Wow! You have very good reasoning power and I like that. How about this example? The quantity 2y raised to 5. What is the base and the exponent?
Ma'am, in the expression quantity 2y raised to 5, the base is 2y and the exponent is 5.
Why did you include 2 in your base?
Ma'am, I included 2 as the base also because quantity 2y is taken as 1 and so they both have an exponent of 5.
Yes, you are right. Parentheses is a sign of groupings and so quantity 2y is taken as 1. Therefore, they both have an exponent of 5. Any question, dear learners?
None, ma'am.
All right. Let's proceed to the rules of exponents on page 1 of your learning activity sheets. There are 5 rules of exponents. The first rule is product rule. Will you state the product rule, dear learners?
Ma'am, the product rule states that to multiply 2 exponents with the same base, we keep the base and add the powers.
Very good! Product rule states that to multiply 2 exponents with the same base, we copy the same base and add the powers. Illustrating it, we have a raised to m times a raised to n equals a raised to m plus n. For example, x cubed times x raised to 4 equals x raised to 3 plus 4 equals x raised to 7. Can you follow, dear learners?
Yes, ma'am!
Let's try this expression. Simplify 3 squared times 3 raised to 4. Again, simplify 3 squared times 3 raised to 4. Ready? Go, go, go!
3 squared times 3 raised to 4 is equal to 3 raised to 2 plus 4, which is equal to 3 raised to 6, ma'am.
That is correct. 3 squared times 3 raised to 4 equals 3 raised to 2 plus 4 equals 3 raised to 6. 3 raised to 6 is equal to
729, ma'am.
Perfect! 3 raised to 6 is equal to 729. You can use your calculator in simplifying your answers, dear learners. How about x raised to 4 times x? Ready? Go, go, go!
X raised to 4 times x is equal to x raised to 4 plus 1, which is equal to x raised to 5, ma'am.
That's right! X raised to 4 times x equals x raised to 4 plus 1 equals x raised to 5. Let's proceed, dear learners. What is the next rule of exponents?
Quotient rule, ma'am.
Yes, it's the quotient rule. What do we mean by the illustration of the quotient rule? A raised to m over a raised to n equals a raised to m minus n.
A raised to m over a raised to n equals a raised to m minus n means that to divide 2 exponents with the same base, we keep the same base and subtract the exponents, ma'am.
Yes, that is true. A raised to m over a raised to n is equal to a raised to m minus n means that to divide 2 exponents with the same base, we keep the same base and subtract the exponents. Can you still follow, dear learners?
Yes, ma'am!
I hope so. Let's have example number 1. X raised to 5 over x cubed. What is the simplified form of x raised to 5 over x cubed?
Ready? Go, go, go!
Ma'am, the simplified form of x raised to 5 over x cubed is x squared.
Very good! What about y raised to 9 over y raised to 4? What is the simplified form of y raised to 9 over y raised to 4?
Ready? Go, go, go!
The simplified form of y raised to 9 over y raised to 4 is y raised to 5, ma'am.
Absolutely right! Y raised to 9 over y raised to 4 is y raised to 5. Now, let us take the next rule, which is the negative exponent rule. What can you say about the negative exponent rule?
Ma'am, the negative exponent rule says that negative exponents in the numerator get moved to the denominator and become positive exponents. Negative exponents in the denominator get moved to the numerator and become positive exponents. If a number or variable bears a negative exponent, get moved to the denominator and become a positive exponent and have a numerator of 1.
Very well said, dear learner. We have 3 conditions in the negative exponent rule. Condition number 1. Negative exponents in the numerator get moved to the denominator and become positive exponents. What is the simplified form of 3x raised to negative 7 over z squared? I repeat, what is the simplified form of 3x raised to negative 7 over z squared? Ready? Go, go, go!
Ma'am, the simplified form of 3x raised to negative 7 over z squared is 3 over x to the 7th power z squared.
Wow! Perfect! It is 3 over x raised to 7 z squared. X bears a negative exponent, so move it to the denominator and become a positive exponent. So, the simplified form is 3 over x raised to 7 z squared. Let us have condition number 2. Negative exponents in the denominator get moved to the numerator and become positive exponents. What is the simplified form of 2a cubed over 5b raised to negative 8? Again, what is the simplified form of 2a cubed over 5b raised to negative 8? Ready? Go, go, go!
Ma'am, the simplified form of 2a cubed over 5b raised to negative 8 is 2a cubed b raised to 8 over 5.
You got it right! The simplified form of 2a cubed over 5b raised to negative 8 is 2a cubed b raised to 8 over 5. B bears a negative exponent, so get moved to the numerator and become a positive exponent. Let us have the last condition. If a number or variable bears a negative exponent, get moved to the denominator and become a positive exponent and have a numerator of 1. What is the simplified form of 5 raised to negative 2? Again, what is the simplified form of 5 raised to negative 2? Ready? Go, go, go!
Ma'am, the simplified form of 5 raised to negative 2 is 1 over 5 squared, which is equal to 1 over 25.
Yes, you are right! 5 raised to negative 2 is 1 over 5 squared, which is equal to 1 over 25. Let us have the last two rules after a short reminder.
Nako, malapit na ang pasahan ng outputs.
Retrieval time na naman. Narito ang mga dapat mong tandaan sa pagpasa ng outputs mo, Kadonian.
Tiyaking nakasulat ang iyong pangalan sa bawat subject na iyong ipapasa.
Oops, huwag ding kalimutang isulat ang iyong seksyon kung saan ka kabilang.
Mahalagang lagyan din ng label na week 1,
week 2, 3, o 4 ang iyong outputs kung anong aralin.
At bilang nito, upang malaman ng guro kung kumpleto ang iyong ipinasang outputs sa bawat linggo. Kadonian!
Maaari, isulat din ang pangalan ng iyong guro sa bawat subject.
Kung may color coding, sundin ito upang madaling malaman ng iyong advisor at maibigay sa tamang guro.
Paghiwalayin ang mga sagutang papel sa bawat subject.
Huwag paghaluin ang iyong mga sagot sa dalawang subject sa iisang papel.
Kung masusunod mo ang mga ito, tiyak ang mga guro ay hindi malilito.
Sa pagpasa ng mga outputs, tiyaking maayos at organisado.
Ayusin ang output batay sa mga sumusunod na bawat aralin.
Una, sagot ng mga gawain. Pangalawa, reflection.
Pangatlo, lingguhang pagtataya.
At pangapat, summative test kung mayroon.
Isang paalala mula sa pamuno ng Doña Aurora National High School at ng istasyong ito.
We're back! Are you still with me, dear learners?
Yes, ma'am!
Thank you, dear learners! Let's have the fourth rule. The power rule or powers to powers. In the illustration, quantity A raised to M raised to N equals A raised to MN. What does the power rule tell us?
The power rule tells us that to raise a power to a power, we need to multiply the exponents, ma'am.
That is correct. The power rule tells us that to raise a power to a power, we need to multiply the exponents. Let us apply the power rule.
Let's go!
Example number 1. Quantity x raised to 5 raised to 4. What is the simplified form of quantity x raised to 5 raised to 4? Ready? Go, go, go!
The quantity x raised to 5 raised to 4 is equal to x raised to 5 times 4 is equal to x raised to 20, ma'am.
Very good! Let us have another one. Quantity 2 cubed raised to 4. What is the simplified form of quantity 2 cubed raised to 4? Ready? Go, go, go!
The quantity 2 cubed raised to 4 equals 2 raised to 3 times 4 equals 2 raised to 12, which is equal to 4,096, ma'am.
Fantastic! The quantity 2 cubed raised to 4 equals 2 raised to 3 times 4 equals 2 raised to 12, and it is equal to 4,096. Did you know that the power rule has siblings?
Oh, no!
Oh, yes! Just like humans, animals, and plants, power rule has siblings too. Let's have the first sibling. Power of a product. Power of a product is in the form of quantity AB raised to M equals A raised to M, B raised to M. This means that if we have different bases and one exponent, we just distribute the exponent to each factor of the base. Is it clear, dear learners?
Yes, ma'am.
Let's have an example. Simplify quantity xy raised to 4. What is the simplified form of quantity xy raised to 4? Ready? Go, go, go!
The quantity
xy raised to 4 is equal to x raised to 4 y raised to 4, ma'am.
That is correct. Quantity xy raised to 4 is equal to x raised to 4 y raised to 4. What about the quantity 2x raised to 3? Simplify the quantity 2x raised to 3. Ready? Go, go, go!
The quantity 2x raised to 3 equals 2 raised to 3 x raised to 3, which is equal to 8x cubed, ma'am.
Very good! The quantity 2x raised to 3 equals 2 raised to 3 x raised to 3 equals 8x cubed.
The last sibling is power of a quotient rule, which is in the form of quantity a over b raised to n equals a raised to m over b raised to m, where b is not equal to 0. We simply raise the numerator and denominator to the given power. Adopting this law, how do you simplify quantity 2 over 5 raised to 2? Again, how do you simplify quantity 2 over 5 raised to 2? Ready? Go, go, go!
The quantity 2 over 5 squared is equal to 2 squared over 5 squared, which is equal to 4 over 25, ma'am.
Absolutely right! Quantity 2 over 5 raised to 2 equals 2 squared over 5 squared equals 4 over 25.
Now, let us have the fifth and the last rule of exponents, which is the zero exponent rule. Can you state the rule on how to simplify expressions with zero exponents?
Ma'am, zero exponent rule states that any number or variable raised to zero power is always equal to 1.
Marvelous! Zero exponent rule is in the form of a raised to 0 equals 1. If we have 3 raised to 0, then it is equal to
1, ma'am.
That is correct. Why did you say so?
Ma'am, zero exponent rule states that any number or variable raised to 0 power is always equal to 1. And 3 raised to 0 bears a 0 exponent. Therefore, 3 raised to 0 is equal to 1.
Marvelous! What about the quantity 5x cubed y raised to 4 raised to 0? What is the simplified form of the quantity 5x cubed y raised to 4 raised to 0?
1, ma'am!
Perfect! Very easy, right, dear learners?
Yes, ma'am!
Now, let us check whether you understood the rules of exponents. Open your learning activity sheets on page 2, activity 1, titled, What's Missing? You are to find the missing factor in the product sentence. Let us have the first one. 12a raised to 5 equals quantity 2a cubed. What is the missing factor of 12a raised to 5 if one factor is quantity 2a cubed? Ready? Go, go, go!
Yes, ma'am. My answer is 6a squared.
Good job! How did you get your answer?
Since I am looking for the other factor of 12a raised to 5, given 2a raised to 3, I divided 12 by 2 and I keep the base a and subtracted the exponents. So I got 6a squared.
Very good! You really understood our lesson. Number 2. 15a raised to 4, b raised to 6. The first factor is negative 5a cubed b raised to 4. What is the other factor? Again, 15a raised to 4,
b raised to 6. And the first factor is negative 5a cubed b raised to 4. What is the other factor? Ready? Go, go, go!
Ma'am, negative 3ab squared.
You got it right! The other factor is negative 3ab squared. Let us have activity 2 and check whether you really mastered the rules of exponents. Still on page 2 of your learning activity sheets titled Simply Me. You are to simplify each of the following expressions. Let us have number 8. Quantity 4b raised to 2 times quantity 4b raised to 3. What is the simplified form of quantity 4b raised to 2 times quantity 4b raised to 3? Ready? Go, go, go!
16b to the 5th, ma'am.
How did you get your answer?
I multiplied the two bases, 4 and 4, which is equal to 16, and add the exponents 2 and 3, which is 5, ma'am.
What rule of exponents did you use?
I used power law, ma'am.
And what is power law, my dear?
Power law states that to multiply the two exponents with the same base, keep the base and add the exponents, ma'am.
That is absolutely right. What did you do with the base?
I multiplied the base, which is 16, ma'am.
You said keep the base. Did you keep the base?
Oh no, I was wrong, ma'am. I should keep the base.
Yes, keep the base and add the exponents. Can you give the correct answer now?
Yes, ma'am. The quantity 4b squared times the quantity 4b cubed is equal to the quantity 4b to the 5th, ma'am.
Very good. Is the quantity 4b raised to 5 already in the simplest form, dear learners?
Not yet, ma'am.
What is the simplest form of quantity 4b raised to 5?
The quantity 4b raised to 5 is equal to 4 raised to 5 b raised to 5, which is equal to 1024 b to the 5th, ma'am.
Marvelous! Now you really can follow. Don't be afraid if you have committed mistakes, because from your mistakes, you will learn more. Just be humble to accept your shortcomings and be ready to make things right. Let us have a short break before we have a recap of our lesson today.
Do you encounter problems in accomplishing the different activities in your modules or learning activity sheets?
Worry no more, because your teachers are always ready to guide and assist you. You can send your questions or clarifications in two easy ways. 1. Call or text, and 2. Private message. So easy, right? Remember, at Doña Aurora National High School, we make amazing things possible.
This reminder is brought to you by Doña Aurora National High School and this station.
We're back! If you still have questions on how to do the activities, you can message or call your teacher in Mathematics 7. Let's summarize our lesson for today. What have you learned for today's lesson?
We learned that the exponent is the small number or letter or any symbol written at the upper right corner of an expression. It tells how many times the base is to be multiplied by itself, ma'am.
Splendid! Can you name the rules of exponents and their subcomponents?
The rules of exponents are product rule, quotient rule, negative exponent rule, power of a product, power of a quotient, and zero exponent rule, ma'am.
Very good! Just don't forget these rules and their processes
so that you can answer all the activities in your learning activity sheets. You will use them in multiplying and dividing polynomials. Let us apply the different rules of exponents in this activity. In this activity, you are going to determine whether the statement is a fact or a bluff. Are you ready, dear learners?
Yes, ma'am!
Number 1 is 10 raised to 7 over 10 raised to 5 equal to 100? Again, is 10 raised to 7 over 10 raised to 5 equal to 100? Is it a fact or a bluff? And why did you say so? Ready? Go, go, go!
It is a fact, ma'am. Applying the quotient rule, I subtracted the exponents and it becomes 10 squared and 10 squared is equal to 100.
Marvelous! You are correct. How about quantity 2x cubed times quantity negative 6x squared raised to 2 equals 12x raised to 7? Is quantity 2x times negative 6x squared raised to 2 equals 12x raised to 7? Is it a fact or a bluff? Ready? Go, go, go!
It's a bluff, ma'am.
Why did you say it's a bluff?
Applying the power rule and its components, the answer is 72x raised to 7, ma'am.
Very good! For your last activity, how will you apply your learnings about exponents in your daily life? Anyone?
Ma'am, applying the negative exponent rule in my life as a student, I will change my negative attitude into a positive one. I will spend more time in accomplishing my schoolworks before playing computer games, ma'am.
We will do the same, ma'am.
That's nice to hear, dear learners. In order for you to get high grades, you need to spend most of your time in studying your lessons. Convert your negative values into positive values so that your parents will be happy to have children like you. Wow! We're done! Yay! I hope you have learned a lot from our discussions. You are all great, dear learners! Congratulations! If you still have questions on how to do the activities, you can message or call your teacher in Mathematics 7 through their mobile phones or messenger. I would like to acknowledge the teachers behind this RBI lesson. Teacher Jenny D. Carino, our scriptwriter. Teacher Jonah A. Buduan, our language editor. And our content editor, Ma'am Merlinda D. Dante, head of the Mathematics Learning Area. Teacher Rufino R. Pumeda Jr. and Teacher Mardi C. De La Cruz, our technical specialists. I am Teacher Rowella S. Santos, your radio teacher, leaving you this quote from Albert Goodwill Spalding. Think of your power as the exponent in an equation that determines the value of information. The more power you have, the more additional power you derive from new data. Goodbye! Keep safe, everyone!
Calculus,
advanced algebra,
intermediate algebra, trigonometry,
elementary algebra,
geometry, mga aralin na dapat tuklasin.
Mathematics Learning Area.
Mathematics, kahit saan, kahit kailan.
Mathematics, maaasahan.
Inyong tututukan dito sa
106.3
Dance Radio.
Learning is amazing!
Dance Radio, sinig-aralan sa radio, atin namin.
wala nang makakapigil pa. Sulong Arangkada 106.3 Dance Radio sa Aurora, Isabela.
Edukasyon sa sulong, basta na magtulong-tulong, sulong edukalidad. Dance Radio, learning is amazing.
Okay, and we're back. Thank you so much ano, sa pakikinig at talagang kami ay nag-monitor ng mga comment. Hindi ko makonek kung paano magkakasya ang whiteboard dito. At siguro, anak, hello, Redelmar. Shout out sa'yo ha. Baka protractor yon. Or talagang tractor ang gusto mo. Okay, so I think we are ready to reveal the winner of 30 pesos worth of load. Okay, dahil dyan, i-reveal ko na. Ganon kabilis. Walang kaklu-klu. Naghihintay pa lang tayo ng clue. May nanalo na po. At eto na, ang laman ng kahon. Ibibigay na po natin. Para naman medyo kiligin sila. Ang daming nag-comment. Ano ang laman? Okay, eto na po. Ayan. Eto po ay ating module. Ang daming nag-comment ng module, pero nakita nila agad. Yung unang pumasok. Pasok na pasok ang pangalan galing sa Seven Sinning. Wow, congratulations, Erica May Rigon. Ikaw ang nanalo ng 30 pesos worth of load. Ayan. So kaya kayo, nood, manonood dyan, manood lang, comment lang ng comment, malay nyo. Yung isa kanina, bond paper, papel, naging folder na. Okay. Ibigay na natin ang question number one para naman may manalo ulit. Go, 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 Ma'am Janice. Ano ba unang tanong?
Para sa ating question number
parang
one.
Parang wala, sir. Ayan. Question number one na po tayo.
Question number one po natin.
Yes, sige,
the
ma'am.
Question is, what is the product of the square of the quantity negative 3 and the cube of the quantity 5 over 3? A, 125 over 27. B, 125 over 3. C, 15. D, 15 over 3 or 5.
Ayan, you can send your entries. Ano? Kailangan nakalagay po dyan ang name, section, question number 1, paki-indicate po. And your answer, of course, and cell phone number. Thank you so much, Ma'am Larna, sa ating load na binanggit ko na kaninang umpisa. Okay, ibigay na po natin ang floor sa ating mga facilitators para sa first part of discussion. Go, go, go! Hello, hello, hello. Good afternoon. Naririnig na ba ako? Ayan. So, dito tayo. So, mag-review muna tayo, mga anak. Okay, so bago yan, gusto ko munang batiin ang aking mga advisee. Ang grade 7, Del Pilar. Hello sa inyo, mga anak ko. And syempre, shout out din sa mga hawak kong students ng 7 Jacinto, 7 Lapu-Lapu, 8 maroon at 8 lavender. Yan, hello sa inyong lahat. Sana ay nasa mabuti kayong kalagayan palagi at ready para sa ating live. Yan, so let us have the review muna mga anak. Okay, so what is an exponent? Okay, so it says there, exponent is a shorthand way to show a larger number. Ayan. So, ito yung shortcut natin para maipakita yung mga larger number. Gagamitan natin siya ng exponent. Number 2, it is the small letter or number or any symbol written at the upper right corner of an expression. So, saan siya nakalagay? Nasa upper right hand siya ng base. Okay, small letter lang siya. And then, ano naman yung gamit niya? It tells how many times the base taken as a factor.
and number of times. Okay? So, siya yung magsasabi kung ilang beses mong imumultiply yung sarili niya sa sarili niya. Yung base sa sarili niya. Okay? And then, exponents are sometimes referred to as powers. So, tinatawag din natin siyang powers. Okay. So, where is an exponent located at? Next slide po, ma'am. Saan naman natin matatagpuan yung exponent? So, dito, okay, yung 6 ay tinatawag natin siyang base. So, yung maliit na number sa upper right hand niya ang tinatawag nating exponent. Ayan, maliit lang siya na nasa upper right corner. Okay, so what does an exponent mean? Ano naman ang ibig sabihin ng exponent? Okay, so we will use an example of how the secret spreads fast to explain what does an exponent mean. So, ayan, i-explain natin siya using an application sa real life. So, paano siya nagagamit? Okay, so how does a secret spread so fast, partner? Paano ba kumakalat ang isang sikreto ng ganun kabilis? Okay, so ayan. Ako na lang part. So una, kung ako halimbawa, meron akong secret. Okay. The person with the secret tells a friend. Sasabihin ko kunwari kay Ma'am Mardy. Ayan. Si Ma'am Mardy, ayan, laging mahilig sa ano, Marites. Ay, sorry. Joke lang, ma'am. Okay. Kunwari si Ma'am Mardy ay Marites. Ayan. The friend, siya siyempre pinramis niya sa akin na hindi niya sasabihin yung sikreto, di ba? Ganun naman kapag meron tayong friend, meron akong sasabihin, secret lang natin. Pero wag mong sasabihin, ha? Nag-promise siya sa akin na hindi niya sasabihin, kahit kanino. And then, that same friend breaks the promise and tells two more friends. Yan, sinabi niya sa dalawa pang kaibigan niyo. Yan. Nag-break siya ng promise. Hindi naman naiiwasan yun. Hindi lang naman siyang nagbe-break ng promise. Marami dyan. Okay? And then, the two new friends tell two new friends too. Yan, sinabi din niya sa yung dalawang kaibigan na yon, nagsabi pa sa tagdadalawang kaibigan nila ulit. And then, the two new friends decide to tell two more friends. So, yung dalawa ulit na kaibigan na yon, tagdalawa, nagsabi ulit sa tagdadalawa. And then this pattern occurs over and over until many people have been told. Ayan. So, paulit-ulit na lang nangyari hanggang ang dami-dami nang nakaalam nung sikreto mo. By the end of the day, it is no longer a secret. Ayan. So, ganun. Ganun ka, naging chismis na naging ano ka na, talk of the town. Okay. So, lesson learned. Be careful of whom you tell your secrets. Ayan. Next slide po. So, in an exponential expression, the base is the factor and the exponent tells the amount of times to multiply that number by itself. So, that is a mouthful. Kagaya nga nung pag-spread ng secret kanina. So, ganun din kadami dito sa may exponential factor. Exponential expression natin. So, just like when we have 3 to the 4th power, your base is 3 and your exponent is 4. Okay? A base is a number that can be expressed using an exponent. And then, an exponent is the small number and is referred to as a power. So, we mean 3 raised to 4 means 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 or 81. Mali yun. Dapat ang exponent nun ay 3. I'm sorry po. So, that is 3 raised to 3 should be 27. Pag 3 raised to 4, it should be 81. Oo nga. Okay. So, next na kay Ma'am Mardy.
Okay. Ayan. So, ako na agad para hindi naman kayo magsawa. Okay, magandang tanghali sa lahat ng mga grade 7 learners natin, lalong-lalo na sa aking mga 7 Newton, 7 Galileo, and 7 Archimedes. And of course, sa aking tatlong chikiting, John D, Dion, and Jundi. Okay, so for the continuation of our discussion, let us discuss the laws of exponents na na-discuss na kanina sa RBI ninyo. So ipapakita lang namin, magpapakita lang kami ng mga ilang examples para ma-visualize nyo naman yung na-discuss kanina sa RBI. So we are going to discuss the product rule, quotient rule, the negative exponent rule, power rule, and the zero exponent rule. Okay, so doon na tayo sa una. We have the product rule. So for product rule, so kung nakinig kayo kanina, eto siya. We have a raised to m times a raised to n equals a raised to m plus n. So kung titignan ninyo yung rule, simpleng-simple, this says that to multiply two expressions with the same base, dapat parehas ang base natin. So kung titignan nyo dyan sa illustration natin, parehong a ang base niya. You keep the base, kopyahin lang ang base, and then add the powers. So yung powers niya, m at saka n, just add. Hindi nyo imumultiply, add ang powers. Okay, let's have examples. X raised to 7 times x raised to 8. I-add lang ang exponents. 7 plus 8 is 15 dahil parehas naman silang x ang base. For number 2, parehong y ang base. Add lang ang exponents. 5 plus 4 is 9. So the answer is y raised to 9. For number 3, we have 3 factors. Y raised to 5 times y raised to 4 times y. Take note mga anak, kapag wala kayong nakikitang exponent, ang exponent niyan ay 1. So sabi nga ng mga estudyante noon, invisible 1. So hindi 0 yan, 1. Okay? So pag 0 ang exponent noon, y raised to 0 is equal to 1 yun. Wala na tayong base doon. So yung 1 na ang sagot. So add the exponents, 5 plus 4 plus 1 is equal to 10. So the answer is y raised to 10. So ganun lang kadali ang product rule. So next we have the quotient rule. So for quotient rule, we have a raised to m over a raised to n equals a raised to m minus n. So dito, isusubtract nyo naman ang exponents. So this says that to divide two expressions with the same base, just copy the base and then subtract the powers or the exponents. Okay, let's have examples. X raised to 7 divided by x squared is x raised to 7 minus 2. I-subtract lang yung 7 and 2. So the answer is x raised to 5. Okay, for number 2, kung papansinin ninyo, kung isusubtract ninyo 4 minus 6, huwag nyong pagbabaligtad rin ang pag-subtract. Pag pinagbaligtad nyo yan, 6 minus 4, ang gagawin nyo, ang magiging sagot nyo is m squared. Mali na yon, mga anak. Pero pwede nyo pa rin, of course, pag sinubtract nyo yan, talagang mas mauuna dapat ang mas mataas. Now, kung inuna nyo isubtract, so mas uunahin ang mas mataas, 6 minus 4, at yung mas mataas na exponent ay nasa denominator, dapat ang sagot ninyo ay nasa denominator din. So, 6 minus 4 is 2. Yung sagot ninyo na m squared ay nasa denominator dahil mas mataas yung exponent na nasa denominator. Sa number 1 kanina, mas mataas yung exponent na nasa numerator, kaya yung sagot na doon ay nandun na sa numerator or siya na yung pinaka-answer. Wala na tayong over 1 doon. Wala na tayong denominator. Now, for number 3, okay, paki-observe. For a raised to 5 over a squared, mas mataas yung exponent ng numerator. So yung sagot ng 5 minus 2, yung sagot ay nasa numerator. Whereas for e raised to 4 over e raised to 9, since yung mas mataas na exponent ay nasa denominator, yung sagot natin na e raised to 5 ay nasa denominator. Okay, so wag malilito doon mga anak. So, ang final answer natin for number 3 is a raised to 3 over e raised to 5. Okay, so that is the quotient rule. Okay, let's Let's pass the microphone to the host.
Okay, I think may mga nakakuha na po ng correct answer and we're ready to reveal the correct answer. Partner, ano bang tamang sagot dyan?
Ayan, so ang tamang sagot natin is letter B.
Ayan. Congratulations po sa lahat ng nag-send ng kanilang correct answer. At sa mga hindi po papala rin, join lang kayo at may mga susunod pa tayo. Ayan na po ang ating roulette. Habang inihintay, get ready for question number 2 na agad-agad ay papakita natin pagkalipas lamang ng revelation ng ating winner for question number 1. Again, hindi po hula ang ilalagay niyong code, kundi question 1 answer. Ayan na po, nakikita po natin sa screen ang mga nag-send na correct answers. First 10 po yan. Ayan, sige, congratulations. Kung sino man ang makita nating pangalan, ikaw ay maswerte ngayong araw. Okay, congratulations sa iyo, Ray Christian Sagaysay of 7 Kulturo. O, diba, sabi ko sa iyo, join lang ng join. Congratulations, anak, at sali ka ulit mamaya. Ayan, I think ready na po tayo. Ray Christian, Sagaysay Kultura, paki-comment, i-reply mo ngayong cellphone number para agad-agad ma-monitor ka ng ating team. Okay, for question number 2, eto na po. Abang-abang na. Wala tayong choice, kaya sana tingnan niyong mabuti ang nasa screen. Simplify 5a raised to negative 3 over 15a raised to negative 5. Ayan po, nasa screen ano, kung medyo hindi nyo naintindihan. Simplify 5a raised to negative 3 over 15a raised to negative 5. Ano kailangan isend nila, partner?
To send your answers, please send your name, section, question number 2, the answer, plus huwag pong kalimutang ilagay ang inyong cellphone number na luloadan.
Okay. Thank you, partner. Of course, balik tayo sa ating facilitators para sa continuation. Go, go, go!
Ayan, I'm back. Dito naman tayo sa negative exponent rule. Okay, ano naman ang sinasabi ng ating negative exponent rule? Ayan. This says that negative exponents in the numerator get moved to the denominator and become positive exponents. Negative exponents in the denominator get moved to the numerator and become positive exponents. Only move the negative exponents. So, kapag ang negative exponent natin ay nasa numerator, ibababa lang natin siya. Magkakaroon tayo ng 1 na denominator, na numerator, and then yung exponent natin na negative n ay magiging positive na siya pero nakalagay na siya sa denominator. Kaya yung a raised to negative n ay magiging 1 over a raised to n. Paano naman kapag nasa denominator yung negative exponent natin? Ayan. So if the exponent is in the denominator, if the negative exponent is in the denominator, itataas naman natin siya. So yung 1 over a raised to negative n ay magiging numerator na lang at yung n natin na negative ay magiging positive. Kaya ang sagot natin dyan is a raised to n. And then if we have negative exponent on a quotient, we'll have the quantity a over b raised to negative n will be equal to the quantity b over n, b over a, pagbabalik na rin lang natin siya yung nasa loob ng quantity, b over a raised to positive n. Magiging positive na yung n. And then ang final answer natin dyan is b raised to n over a raised to n. Okay, let's have some examples. Okay, number 1. 3 raised to negative 2. So, yung exponent natin is negative 2, magiging 1 over 3 raised to 2. Kaya, ang final answer natin dyan is isisimplify natin yung 3 raised to 2, kaya magiging 9 siya. So, ang final answer natin is 1 over 9. For number 2, we have 5x raised to negative 3. So, that will be 5 over x raised to 3. Yung 5, hindi natin siya ibababa kasi wala naman siyang negative exponent. So, mananatili siya doon sa numerator. So, yung x raised to negative 3 ay magiging denominator. And then, yung negative 3 natin is magiging positive na siya. So, final answer will be 5 over x raised to 3. And then, for number 3, we have the expression 2y raised to negative 2 over 4x raised to negative 6. So, yung y negative 2 natin, y raised to negative 2, ibababa natin siya. So, magiging y raised to 2 na lang. And then, yung x raised to negative 6 na nasa denominator, gagawin natin siyang numerator. And then, magiging positive yung 6. So, ang answer natin dyan, and then we will simplify 2 over 4, and that will be 1 half. So, wala na tayong wala na tayong numerical coefficient sa taas. So, ang matitira na lang is x raised to 6 over 2 y raised to 2. Okay? Let us have the next one, which is the power rule or powers to powers. Yeah. So, power rule says that to raise a power to a power, you need to multiply the exponents. Just like A, lumis yung parenthesis. Okay, lumis lang po yung parenthesis natin. Yung A raised to M ang laman niya. A raised to M and then exponent niya yung N. So, paano natin siya isi-simplify? Imu-multiply lang natin yung mga exponents niya. So, magiging answer natin is A raised to M times N. Or A raised to MN. Okay? Let us have the power of... example. Oh, sorry. So, let's have examples. Number one, quantity A raised to 5 raised to 6. Okay? So, ang magiging sagot natin dyan is A raised to 5 times 6. And final answer will be A raised to 30. And for number 2, we have the quantity A raised to 4 raised to 2. So, 4 times 2 is 8. So, our answer will be A raised to 8. And then for number 3, we have the quantity x raised to 3 raised to 5 is equal to 3 x raised to 3 times 5. And that will be x raised to 15. Okay? Thank you, Ma'am Lorelei. And for power of a product, we have the quantity AB raised to M, and that will be simplified as A raised to M, B raised to M. So, ibig sabihin yan, yung lahat ng nasa loob ng quantity natin, i-raise natin siya sa M. Okay? Ibig sabihin, pareho silang may exponent na M. Kaya yung AB natin is magiging AB raised to M is magiging A raised to M, B raised to M. Okay, let's have two examples for that. Number one, we have the quantity 5x cube y squared raised to 3. So we have 5 raised to 3, x raised to 9, kasi 3 times 3 is 9, and then y raised to 6, kasi 2 times 3 is 6. So simplify, 5 cube will be 125. And then kukopihin lang natin yung x raised to 9, saka y raised to 6. Okay? And then let us have number 2. Okay, let's have the quantity of 3a squared multiplied by the quantity 6b to the 4th and raised to 2. So, we'll have 3a squared raised to 2 and multiplied by 6b to the 4th raised to 2. And that will be 3 squared a to the 4th multiplied by the quantity 6 squared b to the 8. Okay? So, imu-multiply natin yung mga exponents. So, we'll have 3 squared is 9 a to the 4th multiplied by 6 squared is 36 and then b to the 8. So, final answer will be 9 times 36 is 324 and then we'll copy a to the 4th and b to the 8 power. And then let's have the power of a quotient. For power of a quotient, we'll have the quantity A over B raised to N. Okay, erase natin both the numerator and the denominator by N. So we'll have A raised to N over B raised to N. Okay, let's have examples. Example number one, we have the quantity A over B squared, raised to 2 or raised to 2. So we'll have the answer, A raised to 2 over B raised to 2. Pareho silang ma-exponent na 2. Okay. Example number 2, quantity X squared over Y cubed raised to 3. Okay? So we'll have X squared raised to 3 will be X raised to 6 kasi multiply natin pareho yung exponents niya. And then Y cubed raised to 3 will be Y raised to 9. So final answer will be X raised to 6 over Y raised to 9. And then for number 3, we'll have 3x squared, the quantity 3x squared over 4y cubed raised to 2. Okay, so lahat yung nasa loob, erase natin siya sa second power. So 3 squared and then x squared raised to 2 will be x to the 4 over 4 squared and then y cubed raised to 2 will be y to the 6th power. And then simplifying the expressions, we'll have 9x to the 4th over 16y to the 6th power. Ayan. And for the last one, we have the zero exponent rule. Okay? For the zero exponent rule, a raised to 0 is equal to 1. This says that anything raised to the 0 power is 1. So kahit gaano pa kahaba yung expression mo, kung ang exponent niya ay 0, 1 lang ang katapat nun. Okay? So let's have an example. Number 1, 112 raised to the 0 power is equal to 1. Number 2, the quantity of 3x squared y cubed z to the 5th raised to 7 raised to 0. And that will be equal to 1. Okay? So kasi sa dulo, meron siyang exponent na 0. And then for number 3, we'll have the quantity 3 squared x to the 4th over 4 squared y to the 6th raised to 0. And that will be equal to 1 only. Okay? So, I hope naintindihan. Back to you. Ayan.
Thank you so much po sa ating facilitator. Anong galing-galing ni ma'am, ano? Pwedeng-pwede ka palang isabak quickly. Ayan, sa ating question number 2, nabibili ba ko sa ating mga estudyante na without choices, talagang nasagot nila. Ayan na po ang correct answer natin while waiting for the magic roulette. A squared over 3. Applying the negative exponent rule, kapag may exponent tayong negative, nasa baba, itaas nyo lang mag-positive. Kung nasa taas, ibaba nyo mag-positive. Congratulations sa iyo, Luke Benko of 7 Zamora. Please comment your cell phone number again para sa verification and sa pagsend ng iyong premyo. Ayan, wag na nating patagalin. Ibigay na natin ang question number 3. Ayan, ano bang pangatlong tanong? Abangan po sa screen. Mababasa nyo. Ayan.
Okay. Para sa ating question number 3, we have find the product of the quantity x plus 3 and the quantity x minus 3. A, x squared plus 9. B, x squared minus 9. C, x squared minus 6x plus 9. And letter D, x squared minus 6x minus 9.
Ayan, please send your entries, yung correct po na template, name, section, question 3, your answer and your cellphone number sa ating comment section para naman kayo na ang susunod na manalo. Again, dahil mabilis ang oras, ibalik na natin sa kanila, maipagpatuloy ang nasimulaan. Go, go, go!
Ayan. So, ituloy na natin. So, this time, we're going to discuss multiplication of
polynomial. So kaya namin diniscuss sa inyo ang laws of exponents dahil dito ninyo gagamitin yung mga laws natin. So for multiplication of polynomials, ang gagamitin natin ay ang product rule at yung power rule. Okay, so to multiply monomial by another monomial, so take note, pag sinabing monomial, one term lang yan. So wala siyang karugtong na plus or minus another expression. So to find the product of two monomials, multiply the numerical coefficients or the numbers. Then, so yun ang una nyong imu-multiply. Then multiply the literal coefficients or the variables using the laws of exponents. So ibig sabihin ng literal coefficients, yan yung mga nakikita nyo, mga letters na karugtong nung number kung meron mang number. Okay, so laws of exponents ang gagamitin natin. So let's have some examples. Okay, so ganyan ang monomial. One term lang. Okay, so for number one, we have the product of 4x and negative 3x squared. So first step natin, i-multiply natin ang numerical coefficients. 4 times negative 3 is equal to negative 12. And then for the variables or the literal coefficients, x times x squared is x raised to 3. Bakit naging x raised to 3? The exponent of x is 1 plus the exponent of another x is 2. So ang ginamit natin dito is the product rule dahil meron silang parehong base, which is x. Okay, so the final answer is negative 12x cubed or x raised to 3. For number 2, okay, marami na yung ginamit dito. Meron na rin tayong i-apply na negative exponent rule. So we have here the quantity 3x raised to 5y times the quantity 2x squared y cubed z raised to negative 5 raised to the power of 2. Okay, so ihuhuli natin yung exponent na nasa labas. Unahin natin yung mga nasa loob. So una, multiply the numerical coefficients. 3 times 2 is 6. And then, ang meron lang na mga variables na parehas sa dalawang factors ay x at y. So for x, we have the exponent of x is 5. X raised to 5 times x squared. So add the exponents. 5 plus 2 is 7. So we have here x raised to 7. Para naman sa y, ang exponent ng y is 1. At sa isang factor is y cubed. So 3. 1 plus 3 is 4. So the answer is y raised to 4. And since walang ka-partner, si z raised to negative 5, walang z sa unang factor, just copy z raised to negative 5. Now this time, gagamitin natin ang power rule. Yung 2 sa labas, imu-multiply natin sa mga exponents ng bawat variable and even the numerical coefficient. So yung 6 natin, magkakaroon din siya ng exponent na 2. So that is 6 squared. Kaya siya ay 36. 6 times 6 is 36. For x naman, 7 times 2 is 14. So we have x raised to 14. And then for y, 4 times 2 is 8. So we have y raised to 8. And then z, negative 5 times 2 is negative 10. So we have z raised to negative 10. So i-apply natin this time ang negative exponent rule. Hindi na natin gagalawin yung 36x raised to 14, y raised to 8. Ang gagalawin na lang natin is z raised to negative 10. So ang rule natin kanina, pag may negative exponent tayo, mapupunta na siya sa denominator. Kaya nandyan na siya sa baba. At tatanggalin na natin ang negative sign. So magiging over z raised to 10. So that is now the final answer. Okay, next, another multiplication naman. Monomial by a polynomial. So this time, monomial, so that is one term, polynomial, eto na yung may karugtong na plus or minus. So marami na siyang terms. So to find the product of monomial by a polynomial, distribute the monomial to each term of the polynomial, then follow the rules in multiplying monomial by another monomial. So babalikan pa rin natin yung una kaninang ginawa natin na monomial by monomial. Okay, so to illustrate this, let's look at this example. Number one, we have 5x squared. Ayan, ang sakit sa mata. Nasilaw ako. 5x squared times the quantity, eto yung polynomial natin, 2x squared plus 3x minus 9. So meron tayong polynomial with 3 terms. 2x squared, 3x, and negative 9. So ang gagawin natin, i-distribute natin yung 5x squared to every term. So i-multiply natin siya. Okay? So i-direct na natin i-multiply yung numerical coefficient. 5 times 2 is 10. So isulat nyo na agad doon. X squared times x squared is parehong may base na x. So add the exponents, 2 plus 2 is 4. So ididikit lang yon. So the first term is 10x raised to 4. Next term, 5x squared times 3x. So nasa second term na tayo. 5 times 3 is 15. So since parehong positive, kaya plus yung karugtong niya. X squared times x, ang exponent niyan is 1. So 2 plus 1 is 3. Kaya 15x raised to 3. And for the last term, 5 times negative 9 is negative 45. So huwag kakalimutan yung sign doon. Yan na yon yung minus sign niya. And then x squared, since wala naman ng literal coefficient ang 9, just copy x squared. So that is now the final answer. So ganun lang, simpleng-simple, i-distribute nyo lang yung monomial to every term or i-multiply nyo to every term of the polynomial. Okay, for number 2, ayan, tandaan mga anak yung ating rules sa multiplication of integers. Like signs, positive. Pag unlike signs, negative. Negative 2xy times the quantity negative 3x cubed plus 2x squared plus 4x plus 7. So negative 2 times negative 3 is positive 6. X times x raised to 3, 1 plus 3. Exponent ng x is 1 plus 3, so 4. Ang exponent ng y natin is 1, so just copy kasi wala naman siyang kasama dun sa loob. So copy lang yung y. Negative 2, next term na tayo, negative 2 times positive 2 is negative 4. And then x raised to 1 times x raised to 2, add the exponents, x, that is x raised to 3. And then copy y. Kopyahin lang ang y. Next, negative 2 times 4 is negative 8. Idugtong nyo lang yon. Huwag nyo nang ilagay na plus negative 8. Idugtong nyo na mismo yon. Minus 8 na siya. And then x times x is x squared. Kasi 1 plus 1 is 2. And then copy y. And for the last term, negative 2 times positive 7 is negative 14. So idugtong na yon. Yun na yung sign niya. Minus 14, copy na lang yung literal coefficient na xy. So that is multiplication of monomial by polynomial. And for the last, we have multiplication of binomial by another binomial. Ito na yung nasa question number 3. Okay, so tandaan to para makasagot kayo sa question number 3. So the distributive property and the FOIL method can be used to find the product of two binomials. So when we say FOIL, F is for the first term. Ibig sabihin nun, i-multiply nyo muna yung dalawang first term ng dalawang binomial. Then O is for the outer, yung mga nasa labas na terms. I is for inner, yung mga nasa loob. And L is for the last or the last terms. Okay, so to illustrate this, let's have this example. x plus the quantity x plus 2 times the quantity x minus 4. Okay, yan. So, una, we have f or the first terms. Ano ang first term ng bawat binomial? We have x times x. Yan. So, that is x squared. Dahil lang exponent nila ay parehong 1. So, 1 plus 1 is 2. For the outer terms, ibig sabihin yung nasa labas na mga terms, and that is x at saka yung 4 sa kabila. X times negative 4 is negative 4x. Unahin lang lagi ang numerical coefficient and then idikit lang yung literal coefficient. Inner terms, yung nasa loob naman, that is 2 and x. So, 2 times x, pagdikitin lang din. Unahin lang basta yung numerical coefficient. So, that is 2x. And for the last terms, yung last term ng first is 2. Last term ng second is negative 4. So, 2 times negative 4 is negative 8. Now, kung papansinin ninyo, meron tayong tinatawag na similar terms or like terms. Ibig sabihin nun, parehas silang may x na ang exponent ay parehas din. So, yun ang similar or like terms natin. They are negative 4x and positive 2x. So, we're going to combine. Kasi pag mag-a-add tayo ng monomials, ang ia-add lang natin ay yung numerical coefficient and copy the literal coefficient. So, negative 4x plus 2x is negative 2x. So, the final answer is x squared minus 2x minus 8. So, yung division malamang, Ma'am Jenny, i-discuss na lang ng mga subject teachers sa ating mga klase. Okay? Meron pa dapat tayong division of polynomials. Pero dahil wala na tayong oras, i-discuss na lang sa inyo yan or isesend na lang sa inyo yung PowerPoint presentation. Okay, back to you, our host.
Okay, since binalik sa amin, ano, para naman medyo mas matapos, ibigal balik natin sa ating mga moderator kung meron na bang mga nag-send. Ayan. Thank you po for sending your correct answers. Ayan na. Ang correct answer natin sa number 3 partner ay?
Letter B.
Yes, and congratulations sa iyo. Sino po? Medyo Vin Kafirma of 7 Galileo. Paki-send ang iyong cellphone number sa iyong subject teacher para sa inyong 30 pesos worth of load. Ayan, so today, we discussed the different laws of exponents, the product rule, quotient rule, negative exponent rule, power rule, and zero exponent rule. So dahil dyan, salamat po sa mga nakijoin ngayong araw at talagang gusto man naming mag-stay sa inyo nang mas matagal ay limitado ang aming oras. Kaya naman, thank you po sa ating learning facilitators na talagang nagpuyat. Pinagandaan po ang ating presentation ngayon to our facilitator, Teacher Jenny D. Cariño, and Teacher Mardy C. De La Cruz. Teacher Jenny is our presentation designer and our RBI scriptwriter. Bonggang-bongga! Congratulations, Ma'am! Go, go, go! And of course, to our presenter ng PowerPoint sa kabilang side, Teacher Lorelei Vinutura, our electronic raffle organizers, Teacher Judith, and Teacher Mylene. Ayan, of course, shout out din daw kay
our technical specialist, Teacher Joshua Razon Guillermo, our quality assurance officer, head teacher 5 of the math department, Ma'am Merlin Daridante, our assistant principal, Ma'am Ruby Guillermo, the officer in charge, and the chief education supervisor of the division of Isabela, Sir Rodrigo V. Pascua.
Ayan. Thank you so much po sa inyong lahat. My name is Teacher Rowella S. Santos.
And Teacher Janice Simon.
Thank you for staying with us. See you again next time on
Math Alive sa Facebook Live.
Maraming salamat po ang tabayanan ng susunod na RBI lesson ng science. Bye! Thank you!
Calculus, Advanced Algebra, Intermediate Algebra, Trigonometry, Elementary Algebra. Geometry, mga aralin dapat tuklasin. Mathematics Learning Area, Mathematics kahit saan, kahit kailan. Mathematics, maaasahan inyong tututukan dito sa 106.3 DWDR-FM. Basta Dance Radio, learning is amazing! Ito ang 106.3 Dance Radio.
Prepare yourself.
Ang silid-aralan sa radyo, hating namin ay makabagong paraan ng pagtuturo at kaalaman. Mapaumaga, tanghali o hapon man yan, ang istasyong magbibigay impormasyon kahit saan man.
Something big.
All right,
here we go.
106.3 Dance Radio. Doña Aurora National High School, Santa Rita, Aurora, Isabela.
This
106.3 DWBR FM.